Are we getting a free trip or something? What's going on? That's just what I want to know. We got the music going. I just want to know it's going to be free trip giveaway.
As I told my team the other day, our long-term goal with the office is to have our agent appreciation, celebration in Hawaii. That'd be awesome, right? So.
Yeah, it's still in our region.
Oh, Carn, fix your mic.
Fix your mic. Yeah.
My sister Josie, she's on her way to Hawaii.
We have so many people in Hawaii. Man, they came around. Everyone's in Hawaii. So.
That's right. We got a lot of offices over there. We can do a joint meeting.
Exactly. We just go over there, hit our sister Maui office, and then go have a party, right? So, right on.
I am perfectly okay with that.
So, okay, please quiet yourselves if you're too loud. COVID standards are relaxing, so it's looking like June 15th, people. June 15th, we're going to be starting to do live classes again and live team meetings. So mark your calendars. We're going to be excited. Ignite will be done, and we're retrofitting the office. If you see Vince, our Market Center Tech Trainer, hanging in the ceilings, it's because we're retrofitting the team meeting room or the training room to handle both live and Zoom events at the same time. It's going to be crazy. So we're excited about that. So thank you, Vince and Carnegie, for making that happen. So on-time drawing, put your number in the chat. If you are chatting it up and you want to win, let's make it happen. 1 to 99, highest without going over or closest without going over, wins. We're going to do this in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, Ghostman.
Thirty-three from Donald Moore.
Oh, 33.
Hey-o.
I'll take it.
Donald Moore, congratulations. You are on time, drawing winner. Thank you for being on time. You will get a little something-something in your text, so look out for that from the Miss.
It's just Samantha. An emoji.
You'll get an emoji. I'm just kidding. You'll get an emoji from Samantha. Emoji. She'll love you. So she'll show you some love.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Tell me something good. What's happening? Hawaii trips all over the place. I know Amy has something good.
Come on, Amy.
Oh, yeah. Tell him, John.
You tell him.
I'm scared. I received an email from someone at Keller Williams, and I didn't think it was anything too big, but I've been asked to speak at the Keller Williams Evolve Summit regarding our coaching program.
Keller Williams, the technology side, and Jason Abrams run a 2-day summit online called Evolve that KWRI run, and they're having a leadership panel with on PC coaches, and they've asked Amy to be on one of the national panels. So congratulations, Amy, for killing it on the PC side, and it's getting noticed not only here regionally but nationally as well. So who knew, you guys who are in coaching, you have you're going to soon to have a nationally recognized PC in your midst coaching you, just so you guys know how good you have it. So, or you guys don't know how good you have it, but now you do. So there you go.
Thanks, John.
Better be prepared.
And we'll get that Evolve stuff. So if you want to watch your PC get on the national stage and talk, we will have that ready for you, running on Facebook for you. So.
It's a huge summit. They tried to do it last year and then it got pushed out and they didn't do it. And so this is a big thing. And I believe it's free. You just have to log on to the Facebook app. Yeah. So everybody should go because you'll probably get a lot out of it.
Yeah, it's very, very good. I was on it 2 years ago when they first got it all going. Loved it. Loved it. Loved it.
Humble brag.
What'd you say, Rich?
Got it.
Go ahead, Brad. This is tell me something good. So what do you want to say, Rich?
So we did that Airbnb class, Airbnb and you, and I'm starting to prepare my house to rent out one of my rooms, and I actually started my first LLC, 1660 Boss Parkway LLC. So
awesome. Congrats, man.
Yeah. And I competed in my first BJJ tournament, learning experience. I got another one coming up in a week and a half.
Go, Rich.
I would say I was at that tournament. It was crazy. So it was like, What seems
lots of testosterone.
There was a lot of adrenaline, testosterone floating around. I mean, as soon as you walk in the building, you hit it, hits you in the face. So it was crazy. So
anyway, John, I got something good. Picked up another listing yesterday. Little three bedroom, two bath. I'll announce it in the deal. We're not going to put it on until June. Thank you.
Anyone else? Tell me something good. Come on, there's a lot of you. I know some good stuff is happening.
I finally, I got an escrow closed and I'm working on a listing. So, yay.
Serena, awesome. Love that you're finding success. Congratulations on your first escrow close. Oh, first listing. Wow. Maybe there's something in the water. Maybe it's a coach. Maybe it's a little motivation. I love it. So let's go.
Oh, John.
Bill.
The thing that you signed off, that referral on me for Florida, that woman finally went in there and got started on it. You know, she talked with a person I know in Sacramento here who's I'm helping her, you know, but she's getting there. I mean, then she wants to sell her half a duplex on over there on Walnut, which means
go get the listing. It means go get the listing. That's what that means.
Yeah. So. I got to get listing there. I got to get the referral thing, but at least the referral thing, you saw that.
Yeah, that's good. Okay.
I mean, I tried.
Congrats, Bill. So, anyone else? Tell me something good.
I got something, John.
Yeah. Rose.
So I have my first $1 million listing out here in Woodland. And I'm actually double ending it. And I just got off the phone with the lender that we just got the clear to close. So,
wow. Congratulations, Raul.
Good to go, Raul.
Wow. Ooh. Luxury agent extraordinaire. Who knew, right? So,
look at that. That's
ALC stuff. Good job, Raul.
There would be.
We got two things on our team. Liz got a phone call, so I want to celebrate her victory. She got her first $1 million contract in contract.
Nice. Congrats, Lindsay.
She's on the phone, so she's saying thank you. And then I got my third, which I'm pretty sure I'm checking with Desiree to qualify me for luxury agent, which should close in about a week.
Oh, you need four. Only one more.
Damn it. No, I think I got to talk to Desiree.
He's got three on the books.
I'm chasing four luxury.
You just got two.
So this was my one away.
Yeah.
So I'm pretty sure this must be my fourth to qualify.
Yep. Confirmed.
Jose and maybe Raul, your next luxury realtor is here coming up. So I love it.
Hey yo.
Anyone else? Tell me something good. All right. Let's spin it forward. Congratulations to Anna as our newest capper. Is Anna on? But she's the newest addition to the Michael Soares real estate
team. Taylor.
And she is killing it. I don't know what she's doing, but she writes for her buyer. She writes one contract and it gets accepted. It's pretty crazy. So I don't know what she's doing. So
she's down in San Diego celebrating right now.
Exactly. So say hi to Anna when you see her, but she is killing it. She just capped. Congratulations to her. Julian, are you on there? Where's that Parm Atwell team? So Julian, congratulations on the Patnauer team. Just capped as well. His first year capping. So congratulations to Julian. We're excited about his future and career. So
we're looking to be that cap team. Yeah, I'm cap. Lindsay's cap. Julian's cap. Next is Alicia. Uh-oh.
All capper team. All capper Hall of Fame team. Dang. Okay. All capper Hall of Fame.
Parm's not capped, though.
I'm the only one that's not capped. Like, what's up with that? They're just
Come
kidding.
Come on, Parm. Pick it up.
I'm right. She's good. I'm not carrying my weight around in the team, right?
2021, right. All cappers across.
Hey, it's only like the 25th of the month, okay, people? Okay. So come on now.
Come on.
Carnegie's got some good news. I shouldn't be capped.
Nah, almost. You're close.
Hi, baby, little team. What's up?
Arn, 25 days isn't.
Arn, 25 days. That's good. Yes, okay. 25 days. A lot of agents would love to cap in 25 days. All right. Let's move forward. Reggie, are you on, Reggie? Is Reggie on? Or maybe he's on. So Reggie is joining us. Reggie Powell, he's an awesome guy, actually. When he comes off, say hi to him. He is a firefighter. So he has 2 days on, 4 days off, and he's excited to start his real estate career. He's going to be like, he wants to eventually retire and transition to real estate. He's really excited about it. And so congratulations to Reggie. We're glad we're having him on our team here. So. Jinghua, Jinghua's on here. Oh, I saw you. Hey, Jinghua, unmute yourself. How you doing? Tell us a little about yourself. Oh, you're muted. You're muted. Hold on, Jinghua. Can you unmute her? You're muted.
We could just ask.
Did you? Oh, she's figuring that. Uh-oh. Well, while we figure that out, can you unmute yourself? Did you ask her? Okay.
Yeah.
Jinghua, figure out, unmute yourself. We'll go back. We'll get back to you. Oh, there you are. Hey, there you are.
Oh, you can hear me?
Yes. Jinghua, okay. Tell us more about yourself.
Okay, everything is good to start.
Okay, excellent. So Jinghua, she's like she's like a investor extraordinaire. She owns several houses. She rents out all the rooms in the houses. She rents her own home. So she's like way ahead of the curve. So she's just wanting to get in real estate and make that career happen. We're excited to have her on. She's going to be killing it in the real estate side because she's already doing it on the investor side. So thank you, Jinghua. We were happy to have you here. So
thank you.
Serena, congratulations on your first closing. I know we talked about that, but congratulations. We know that first one is always the hardest, right? So congratulations.
Yay, thank you. Super excited. I was waiting to see my name upon this
on the transaction closing. Yeah, exactly. So congratulations.
Thank you.
Okay, just listed, 196. Woo! Is smoking on the Parm Atwell team. 5 listings so far in May. Eternity 3, Bobby Afton 4, Rich 3, woo! Michael and Taylor 2, Brian Jang 2, Andre 4, Savannah, Kimberly, Jenny, Karen, Serena, Daruba, Lisa, Taylor, Victoria 1, Julie 2, Kathy, Kimberly, Lisa, Dennis, Helen, Joy, Danielle, Glenn, Janelle, and Chantel, all listings in May. Check out the coming soon list because it is hot right now and you can get your people in contract. So congratulations to everyone just listed. Listings are where it's at right now. Guaranteed commission. So pitch your listings. Oh, we have left shark, right shark. What is the shark? Lefty shark. Was it left shark? I think it was left shark. It was left shark, right shark. It was on the Super Bowl. I remember this. So, anyways, sorry.
You need to be left shark. That's the party shark.
The party shark? Is that the party shark, Sam? Or is that the right shark? That looks like the right shark. So,
anyways. Stage left.
All right, so what's up? Anyone pitch their listings? Oh, Rich, we have listings. Pitch our listings.
Well, I was just yelling at Sam right now because we're not luxury and I'm frustrated. So we have Hampton Falls going live later today. It is a 5-3 right across the street from the park, 2620 square feet. We're going to start at 625. We're ready to rock and roll on that. We have Voss Park should be coming up in a couple weeks. It's 1654 Voss Park. It's a 3-2, 1385. They are entertaining offers off market starting next week. We can get in there and walk that one. 1753 Tudor Way is in Plumas Lake. That's a 5-2. I think it's like 1800 or 2,000 square feet. I'll have to check that out. But that's going live later in June as well. So,
hey, that Hampton Falls one is my neighbor. So if anyone buys it and brings me some bad neighbors, I'm going to be pissed at you. So.
Oh, yeah. And 1654 is also, Voss Park is my neighbor. So I don't need 5 Shih Tzus living next door anymore. So,
so you're saying any buyer, we got to run them through you guys first.
Well, Jose, I'll trust you guys, but you got to vet them. There can't be no booty buyers, okay? So,
no booty buyers.
No booty buyers. That's a new one.
What else? Anyone pitch your listings? We got a lot. Are they all on contract?
I'll go.
Serena.
All right. So I have a 3-1 coming up in the Fruit Ridge Manor. It is 1091 square feet, and we're going to go for 327.
Nice. Nice.
What else am I supposed to say? I'm not sure.
They bring a buyer.
Bring a buyer. Bring all of them.
Bring all of them.
No booty buyers.
No booty buyers. Only good buyers.
Hey, John, I've got one coming up. As I mentioned to you before, it's 6,700 Harms. That's H-A-R-M-S Way in Sacramento, 95823. It is a 3-2. It's a little over 1,000 square feet, and we're going to price it about $345.
Nice.
So bring your buyers.
$345, man.
Hey, I know. That's unheard of.
Hey, Cece needs that Fruit Ridge one. Talk to Cece, Steven.
All right. Sounds good. Cece, wait a minute. Is she on the call? She need to talk to me.
Okay. Message Steven T, Cece.
Okay, I'll reach out to you after the meeting.
All right, sounds good.
Hey, John.
Yes.
Is it true that the new builds are canceling contracts because the materials are too expensive and they're going to stop building? Did you hear that?
And for some of you who are more on the construction and build side, the price of lumber has skyrocketed to like 10 times the amount that it normally is. So like to build a fence right now, it's about $40 a foot. Because the fence boards are so expensive. So literally 1 foot, $40. So I haven't heard builders slowing down. They are charging more, I've heard. So we've seen prices increase quite dramatically on new homes. So just so you know, just note that like I was looking at Northlake pricing just recently and they pushed them up a lot, right? So
I heard they're counseling. Keisha posted that she heard that they're counseling stuff. And I don't want that to happen. We got a hard time trying to get these buyers now. What are we going, you know?
It's a crazy market right now. Yeah, we can't, trust me. We're going to have to build a long time anyways to get out of this market. So it's going to be, basically, we haven't built enough in California and especially in Sacramento for a long time. And we could build at record levels for 5-6 years and still be, and finally get back to normal, right? So. That's how crazy it is right now. But yeah, pricing of stuff is going really high. I wouldn't be surprised if it slows down new homes or they're repricing new homes. Yeah, so. I think they're canceling people who are on contract because they have to up the price to make the money work, right? So.
And Lennar is cutting out the broker commission.
Yeah, Lennar has essentially stopped paying commission. So if your buyers want to go to Lennar, sorry, you're out of commission. So, but there's other, obviously other home builders are still doing it, but yeah. Lennar is not having any of it. So, in fact, I had someone go to Lennar and they would even tell, and because of the flexibility in pricing on the stuff, on the materials, they would even tell them the price unless they got pre-approved first. They wouldn't even
Northlake is not taking anybody except cash buyers only.
Yeah. So.
Actually, we just bought one Northlake too. Ours is supposed to close in August. So yeah, I've heard, but ours is not a cash offer. Ours is a loan.
Yeah, they've changed since then. So
yeah,
they have up pricing and they are now.
Yeah, the price has gotten really up.
Yeah, really up. Yeah. So, and that's because materials have gone high. So yes, you are in a crazy market. What happened was when COVID hit, lumber mills got scared and they shut it all down. And lumber mills, you just can't, you know, you can't just, you know, start it up again and all things are great. So it's going to be a while before that comes back. Even pricing of metal and other things is very expensive right now. So any other questions? Picture listings. All right, let's move forward. Just closed in the last week. Look at all the closings in the last week. If you are doing nothing, it's because you're not talking to anyone. My God, let's go. So 475 total closes for the year already. We are pacing dramatically well. Michael and Taylor, 5 closings. Anna, 4. Bobby Afton, 3. Raul, 2. Eternity, 2. Parm, 2. Julian, 2. Beth Beard, 2. Brian, 2. Twan, man, you guys. Dalton, Dexter, Francine, Gina, Rich, Serena, Whitney, Katie, Jenny, and Julie, all closings this week. This week, that man, congratulations to all of you who are closed. You are entered into the unfair share drawing. Serena has her first chance at unfair share drawing. So let's get it going. Let's spin this mug. Maybe Serena wins with her first closing. Let's see. Oh, Gina Borges. Congratulations, Gina. You are our unfair share winning drawer. You will get a little something prize in your text. All right, here we go. You ready? Sam, you want to do this? Carnegie, you want to do this?
I know Sam does.
This is all you, Sam.
Come on. So right. You have been shipwrecked on the island with only one character from the SS Minnow. And if you're too young, you may not know the show, but Gilligan's Island. But if you're older, like Stephen T and myself, you'll know the show. So who would you rather have as your lone companion on the island for a couple years? So you're stranded on the island. You got to pick with a Gilligan Island character. Who would you want to stay with? Oh, I know who I want. I think this is going to depend on how many men and women are on this video.
Watching the results, I don't think so.
Does Sam people... know this show? Does Sam yeah. know this show?
Sam, do you know Gilligan's Island?
No.
Wait, wait, you should have had a category who doesn't know the show.
You got to pick one, man.
There's got to be at least half of the people on here that don't know this show.
I
would even go 80%.
80%. Okay.
If you know this show, you know MASH.
That's right. If you know this show, you know MASH too, exactly. So.
Oh, this is even way before MASH. This is like you're in a different decade.
Era.
Era.
Yeah.
All right. Looks like the votes have stopped. Oh, we got one more in. So let's see. There's a lot of people that are very concerned with their own survival is what I'm gathering from this, which I'm okay with that. Here's what we got.
The professor?
Yeah, the professor. He's smart. And he's cute.
That's literally the only reason I chose him. I figure after a couple of years, you get desperate. Whatever. People would like. Cool.
You gotta have something good to look at. That's what I'm saying, Amy.
If you're stuck 2 years on a freaking island with someone, you better like them, right? So cute. So.
Or Amy Mrs. voted Owl, 12 man. Times. She was
the professor. Oh, yeah, get somebody that can do something.
If it's 2 years and those only men you got to choose from, they all going to start looking good after a while.
Okay. Wow, this team even took a turn I wasn't expecting. So, that was good. Okay. Okay. Hey, we told you to join our Facebook group and like it, but we want to let you know also there is a KW region, Northern California, Hawaii Mastermind Facebook group as well. We recommend you go to that group and try to get into that group because a lot of good stuff from the region comes out there, trainings, advice. You can ask for referrals, you know, those sort of things. So it's a good, this is all Northern California, Hawaii. So all those people going to Hawaii, you know, ask for your referrals. So, but please join it. It's called the All Keller Williams, North Cal Hawaii Mastermind Group. Please get there.
Link is in the chat.
Link is in the chat. I like it. So. Raul. Is Raul here?
Hey, what's up, everyone? So I don't know about you guys, but I had a blast shooting some golf balls on Red Day. We had so much fun that we're actually planning another outing to shoot some golf. It's just for us KW agents, and we're going to be at Hanging Oaks, not this Sunday, but the following Sunday, June 6th. Tea time is pretty early, 7:30. So, you know, it should be plenty of fun. So if you guys want to go out and golf with us, you guys are more than welcome.
Yep. So we're just trying to get some foursomes going, and we'll just go get some, you know, tea times one after another and just go have a good time out there for a little while.
Yeah.
Interested in golf, we're making those reservations. So if you could RSVP sooner rather than later, just so I can make sure we have space for everybody, that'd be great.
Links in the chat.
Links in the chat. We'd love to have you guys part of a foursome, get to know you a little better, spend some time. It's been beautiful. We went out on Sunday, last Sunday, and it was beautiful. I went with Doug and Rich and Donald Moore. So let's make it happen. Love to see you on the golf course. Get to know you a little better. So
it's about $60 for the 18 holes and including the cart.
I'm on the trends. Amy Train.
Hi, how are you? Can I share my screen?
I'm okay.
You can now.
Yeah, thank you. Okay, guys, I'm gonna share my screen real quick. And if you haven't seen this report already, this is an MLS trends report. I'm gonna move this down here. And where you get this from is, you guessed it, on the MLS. So when you log into the MLS and you get into Prospector, you end up here, right? And if you just click on this little button right here that says trends, it will open up another dialogue screen that you can enter in some criteria. I like to use this report when I go on listing appointments. Also, you can use it when you have buyer appointments because you can show them the state of the market in terms that they can understand. And it's from a third party, right? So they're not thinking that you're just telling them something. They can see it right here in writing. So when I pull this report, I like to just pull it for Sacramento, Placer, El Dorado, and Yolo County because that's where our market is. And once you've selected the county or whatever else you want, you can go by zip code. You can go down farther. You can get real granular with this if you want to go specific neighborhood. When you've selected all your criteria, you can click on show chart and it will update. Look at those numbers rise, right? Ooh. And then you click on right here at the top, you can click on market summary. And this is going to put it together in a nice little story for you. You can enter your agent ID and it will brand it to you. Whatever is on your MLS, it will brand it, but you can add more here if you want to. And then you just click market summary and it will download a PDF version, right? So I've got a PDF version here. It's not branded. So I'm gonna give this to Sam to send out for the in the email that she sends out for everybody so that you can use this or you can go in and pull it yourself and brand it. So it's wonderful because it reads just like a story for your clients. And it says April 2021 is a seller's market. No duh. But the next line is really interesting to me. The number of for sale listings was down 56%. We knew that from 1 year ago. We knew we had short inventory, but look at this. It's up 20% from last month, right? So does that mean that more people are listing their homes?
Yes.
Right? It does. And we're going to see that increase keep going, especially after June 15th. So what I would suggest is send this to your sellers that are on the fence. People that are saying, well, I don't really know if I want to sell my home right now. Well, you should get in now because after June 15th, I can guarantee that that number is going to skyrocket. I mean, it's not going to blow up, but I think it's going to continuously increase. And that's what's going to level out our market. I'm okay with that, right? I'm okay with it. It goes on to talk about the number of sold listings has actually increased 49% year over year and increased 9.6% month over month. So that means that real estate is still on the uptick. We're still seeing a really healthy market moving forward. And the number of under contract listings was up 4.7% and it's up 65% compared to the previous year. So this is great. This is really great. When you scroll down, there's going to be more details here. So this is for sale listings, sold listings, and pended listings, right? The next slide is average price per square foot. So the average price per square foot is appreciating. It's been appreciating on a steady incline, you know, for the last year. Also, this is average days on market, list price to sold price percentage. So it looks like right now we've got an average days on market in all the counties of about 12 days and sellers are getting 104 to list price, right? I really like this stat. I'm gonna go back here because I want you guys to use this for yourselves. Go and look up what is your average sold price, list to sold price on your stats. You can look up agent stats and you can find out what yours is. So back when the average for the MLS was 99%, my average was 104%. So I printed out that report and I highlighted that statistic and I brought it with me to listing appointments. And I said, the average agent is getting you 99% to list price. I'm getting my sellers 104% to list price. So it would help, you know, help me sway them. The next one is another favorite of mine that I talk to my sellers about, and it's for sale price versus sold price. So you can see that sold price is on a steady incline up. It's increased quite a bit. The average sold price has gone up. What is that? Almost 150,000. That's pretty good. But what you can see is that the for sale prices just takes a crazy turn up and it just goes above and beyond. So what I say to my sellers is this is fantasy, right? This is what people want to receive for their home, but it doesn't list, on market active listings don't dictate the market, right? Sold listings do. So we don't want to overprice our homes because we will we'll sit on the market, right? And we want to price accurately because these are the people that live in reality. They've sold their home, they've moved on, they've gotten their money, and that's what you want to do. And then it goes on to talk about months of inventory and the absorption rate. So I love this. I probably spent too much time on it with you guys. If you have any questions about it, you can always hit me up after, and it will be included in the email.
What did you get it from?
It's on when you go into MetroList and then you log on to Prospector, you get to here. And then you can click on the trends.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome. Thank you,
Andy. We appreciate it. Thank you from our PC coach. So. Tech teaser. So we got to move this pretty quick. So
I'm horrified by that picture over there. That's just really disturbing. But we're just going back to basics here. Please get your contacts into your database. We're going to be moving forward with a couple things here in the next couple weeks. We're going to be announcing a couple things here. So pretty much start getting those contacts into that database and we will tease a little bit and let you know why coming out here pretty soon.
Yeah.
If you need help with the database import, please email either Vince or myself and we'll be happy to assist you.
Hey, we're super excited. Tomorrow we're having Nick Baldwin come in by Zoom, 2.7 million in business through Facebook ads in 90 days. He's a lab coat agent. So please join us tomorrow. It's going to be a lot of fun. We're going to also stream it in-house here too. So if you want to see it in-house and join your fellow agents, we can do that as well. So you must register for that. So Quantum Leap. If you haven't done Quantum Leap, it is a training for you. If you are always negative talking to yourself and figuring out you're the problem to not how why you're not going forward, you should start with Quantum Leap. So it's a great way to get your personal life organized. If you're worried, if you want to see how to get the mindset of a millionaire and go forward in life and purposeful in life, Quantum Leap is where to go. It will change your life. I guarantee it. So. We're also having Ashley is coming to us. We're very excited about this. She's an introvert and she understands introverts and she's going to be a training on how introverts can be highly successful in real estate. So if you consider yourself an introvert and that you're like, I'm scared to talk to people. Well, she's going to tell you how she became a mega agent, teaching how to do things that make you feel comfortable, even as an introvert. So, We're here to service the extroverts and the introverts, so it's okay here. So we're happy to have Ashley. She's coming in later this month, in June. So June 9th, 11/20. Create Popeye events, June 10th. If you want to join us and do Popeyes and drop stuff off to your clients, we're doing a Popeye, come build your Popeyes. We're going to have more information on this, but June 10th, 2:30 to 4:30, snacks, drinks provided. We're going to help you build and touch your clients. It's going to be awesome. So it's in the chat, so if you want to sign up. Oh, sorry. One more. Disc Profile, Friday, July 2nd. We're having Joey Benedetto come on. He's an expert on disc and how to use personality profiling to convert better. We're very excited to have him on as well. So that's in your chat as well. So, all right. Very happy. I'm very actually excited to have our speaker, Stephen Cooley, on.